What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. I'm Mike Sasser, boudoir photographer in Los Angeles, California, and today I'm finally ready to show you guys what has sped up my workflow by like 20%. I started using this a little over a year ago, and I think it's finally time to share it with you guys. It is this weird looking Gamepad. What I feel like they just like went way overboard. They could tone it down quite a bit, couldn't they? This is not something I'm being repped by. I have legitimately been using a gamepad for over a year to edit all of my photos, and it's been saving me so much time. I think it's really gonna save you a lot of time. So in this video, we're gonna take a look at what slows you down in Lightroom, what's actually the bottleneck in the workflow that takes up so much time, how this gamepad does save me as much time as it does, and I'm gonna walk you through kind of how I use it and how maybe you can use it too. And then at the end, I'm going to, I've exported all the settings that I have for mine. So if you wanna download those, if you guys wanna pick this up, just download them and just put them right into your system. You'll be able to do that too, but let's speed up that workflow. Sound good? I think so. You think so? There's nobody else here. So first, I just want to give a huge thank you to Austin Trenholm. He's the one who set me up with the system in the first place. He showed me how it works and how it can help me out. So I just want to give him a big shout out. If you guys are interested in filmic looking presets, he's got the absolute best ones, the good light presets. So go over there, check him out. Thanks so much for, you know, giving me this knowledge so that I can share it with all of you. So when editing in Lightroom, the problem is that anytime you wanna click on a tool, anytime you wanna select a new tool, you have to either take the mouse away from the image and go up to that tool, or you have to look down at your keyboard to find where it is. Let's say you wanna use the radials filter, that's Shift M, and then you go back to the mouse, you'll go and you'll use it, and then you have to go back and hit Shift M again to get out of that tool. It's just so much back and forth. If you're using the arrow keys with your right hand like I normally like to do, you have to lift up off the mouse, use the arrow keys, and then move your hand back to the mouse. So it's like all this back and forth. It's like if you're trying to go to eat out with a girl and you're asking her where she likes to go, and then she's like, well, where do you want to go? And then you're like, well, I want you to have something that you like to eat, and she's like, I'll eat anything. And then you guys get the point. All right, so let's go ahead and edit this photo the way that I would if I didn't use my gamepad, and we'll just see some of the issues. So the first thing I'm going to do is fix the straightening on this. So I would either tap R, which would bring up the rotate tool or the crop tool. Get there and then tap R again. The other option is to come up and click here, but then again, you're going away from the picture to get up here. Okay, the next thing that I would do, we'll apply a preset. That's not gonna take any extra time. You know, you're gonna have to do that with anything. Probably what we wanna do is brighten her face a little bit, so that's Shift M. And we'll click and drag this, and then Shift M again, and then we're gonna bring the exposure down a little bit, so we gotta roll over to exposure. Now you can either click and drag, but I found that that's not as precise. So what I like to do is just use the arrow keys. When you do that, you have to take your hand away from the mouse to go to the arrow keys. Let's bring the highlights down. Again, I'm taking my hand away from the mouse, and then we'll bring the shadows up a little bit probably. And then we'll increase the vibrance a little bit. That's pretty good. And then her leg has a little something going on, so I'm gonna tap Q. So again, I've gotta look down at the keyboard, find Q, and then roll over it, and then I'll tap Q again. That looks pretty good. So that's probably a pretty finished image. So that's basically what it is. It's going to the keyboard, tapping Q, coming back, finding the thing, going to Shift M, doing that, going to R. It's just a lot of back and forth. So let's reset this here. Now let's take a look at what happens if we use the gamepad. So all of the shortcuts that I use are all pre-programmed on here for their different numbers. For example, spot removal is set to number 11, Shift M for the radial filter is going to be set to 07, crop tool is set to 06, and so on. So instead of typing Q, I'll just hit 11. Okay, so just with this button, I can tap Q. If I do 07, I'm gonna tap that, and that's going to bring up the radial filter tool. So we're gonna do that same thing again. So I'm gonna tap 11, I haven't memorized the numbers. So I'm just gonna crop it. Here, I'm gonna do Shift M, I'm gonna drag this over, that's perfect. I'm gonna tap Q, and I'm gonna be able to get in here and do this. We're gonna do our preset. We'll just use these, tapping down and up, and maybe we'll bring this down, and we can boost vibrance a little bit. And I'm done. All because I didn't have to look at the keys to be able to know what it was I was doing because they're all pre-programmed here on just this hand. I didn't have to lift my hand off of the mouse to go to the arrow keys. I didn't have to hit Shift and M two buttons at once for one command, or if I wanted to use the tools up in the top, I didn't have to keep going back and forth between those. So that's basically how quickly I can do each individual photo. So let's do some math. You guys like math? I liked math. I did pretty good in calculus, but I had a good teacher. I don't know if you had a good teacher. Let's do some math. So let's say it takes about 1 second, you know, give or take, to leave your mouse, to get to the computer, to get to the keypad, and then back to the mouse. And then let's say you have to have, on average, five changes that you need to make to the photo. We're gonna say there is like 1 second and back is a half second. Let's just say 7 seconds extra per photo by going back and doing those things. You do that for 100 photos. Where's my calculator? Okay, so 100 photos times 7 seconds it's 700. And then we're gonna do that divided by 60, because 60 seconds in a minute, 11.6 minutes. You guys, 11 minutes can be saved every session of 100 photos. I don't know about you, but that is crazy to me how much time is saved. So let's take a quick look at what this looks like. So you've got your down arrow, left arrow, right arrow, you know, these arrows. Here's 07 is Shift M, and that'll open up the radial filter. Let's say you wanna use the brush tool, we're gonna make that 4, so you're gonna tap that. I'm gonna tap K. Okay, and now that 05 is now programmed for the brush tool. So I'm gonna tap that, now I can brush over her face. I can brush over all of this. And then I'm gonna tap K, it'll get me out of that tool. Now the last thing I wanna show you, this is a doozy. is that it has something called macros, which is basically you can sync up a series of, it's like an action in Photoshop, you know, you press plan on action, then it does a bunch of steps that you've pre-recorded. So take a look at this. So we're gonna go all the way over. We are going to select this image here. We'll go ahead and apply our preset. We're gonna tap up to boost the exposure. We're gonna throw a vignette on it. That's perfect. We're gonna go up a little bit with the shadows, down a little bit with the blacks. That looks pretty good. Perfect, so let's say this is the edit that I want. I'm gonna hold Shift, and I'm gonna tap over to select all of these, and then with this one button, button 15, it's going to hit Command Shift S, and then the dialogue's gonna pop up, and then it's going to hit Enter, and that's going to sync everything. So I'm just gonna tap 15. Perfect, and then I've got a button to deselect all images, but that first one, and then as I go through, now all of these are exactly synced the same. So let's do that again on like this one here. So let's go ahead and do our preset. We're gonna boost exposure. That's perfect. We'll bring the highlights down a little bit. We'll do that small vignette. And that looks pretty good. I might up the vibrance just a touch. And then we're gonna use Shift M to go ahead and brighten up her face. Now I'm done with this photo. We're gonna hold the Shift key and tap all the way to the right with all of these images. I'm gonna tap the sync button. It's gonna run that for me and sync all of them. And as I click across, now I've got all the images are all synced up. It's beautiful. It's insane. So you guys get the idea. This is crazy. This is crazy how fast and easy it is to go through and edit these pictures. It's like, it's almost like cheating. It's almost like cheating. But now you guys have it too. Now you guys know how to do it, which is going to be so awesome. Now I've seen the loop deck, which I'm sure a lot of you guys are going to comment on. The loop deck is basically a controller that's been designed specifically for Lightroom. Which makes a lot of sense. I get why they made it, but it doesn't solve the problem of needing to look down at the deck every time that you want to make a change. If you say, oh, I need to decrease the saturation in the reds, you have to go down and find the red dial and then scroll down and look up at your screen to see how much you're adjusting. If I want to do that same thing here, I could just scroll down and then in the saturation, I could just tap the down arrow. Tap up the arrow, go to these other ones, and I can go through that so much faster. Plus, this is like $150 cheaper. Faster, cheaper, easier. I think it's a no-brainer. All right, you guys, so if you want that exact layout on the keys for this to be able to use on your own, I'm going to put a link to that where you can just download it and then you'll just import. So you're just gonna bring this up, click these arrows, say import, and then you'll find that file. It's gonna be super easy. And hopefully that saves you like a ton of time. I'm all about saving time, efficiency, just like There are so many more things you could spend your time doing than just like sitting at the computer editing forever. So if you have any questions on this, don't hesitate to ask. If you have any tips on speeding up workflow, definitely share them. Let me know which tools that you use most often in your workflow. If you guys have been waiting for another shooting tutorial, I've got a few of those coming up in the next couple of videos. So if you're not subscribed yet, definitely do that. I also want to say that I've had a few people tell me that they've hit the bell icon, the notifications, but it's not notifying them. They're not getting an email. So the best way to get notified of new videos to go up is either to follow me on Instagram, because I share there, or download, you know, go to my website, boudoircourses.com, and sign up for one of the email lists, because I try and send out and let people know when I'm posting them there. So that wraps it up. You guys have an amazing day. I'm gonna go through and edit this session nice and hastily, with haste. Of haste is with haste. And I hope that you guys go eat some, drink some chocolate milk with your newfound saved time. Let's do this thing.